All right, NHL free agency today, and this is the last I am going to say about it. I have laryngitis. I'm on more steroids than Roger Clemens, but I'm going to use the last of my larynx on this because today was not a great day to be a Toronto Maple Leafs fan, and I'm going to tell you why. There are some reasons to be optimistic. A lot of reasons to be a little, have anxiety a lot. But before we do that, think you know which way it's going to go? Like, your team's going to get a bunch of good players? Well, make your next bet at sportsinteraction.com. Oh my gosh. This is so painful. No more hockey, but we got baseball. You like betting on baseball? If you're going to bet on baseball, go to sportsinteraction.com/SDPN and download the Sports Interaction app, but only if you're 19 plus. Please play responsibly. You know who is not noted for playing responsibly in their own end? John Klingberg, who the Leafs got $4.15 million against the cap. It's just 1 year, so it's not a disaster. But here's the thing. We're talking about making this team more of a playoff contender, more of a team that's going to get more than 5 wins down the tunnel to 16. And we got a guy who had, as a defenseman, 42 points in 70 games. Oh, sorry, that's former Leaf Eric Gustafson, who signed with the New York Rangers for less than $1 million. John Klingberg had 33 points in 67 games! Why did it have to be 67? Now, granted, most of those games were lost to the hellish Anaheim Ducks last year. Super underrated. They were what we thought the Coyotes would be, except they didn't have a goalie. And Klingberg had to try to get offense out of that team. I don't think he was ever going to do that, so we give him a bit of a mulligan. So let's say John Klingberg returns to playing with an actual NHL team form, where he's getting 45, 50, maybe even flirting with 60, 65 points from the back end. Is he capable of doing that on this Toronto Maple Leafs team? And you say, well, Steve, Toronto Maple Leafs are the Toronto Maple Leafs. They got lots of offensive weapons, no matter what you say. They still got John Tavares and Austin Matthews, Mitch Marner, William Nylander, and emerging Matthew Knies, and so on. Ryan Reaves. I thought I would try for the joke. They have Morgan Riley. Now, this reminds me of the Tyson Berry situation that they had in 1920. The 1920 Leafs were a team that will forever haunt my dreams. They were a chore to watch on a regular basis, and then they lost to their own Zamboni driver. What this comes down to is who is going to be the top power play guy. There's Morgan Riley, who's lauded as a good offensive player with not a whole lot of defense. Now, he did some shedding of that in the playoffs, but during the regular season, that's his rep. If John Klingberg has even less defensive ability than Morgan Riley, does he get the top power play slot just to get him those minutes? And maybe you give Morgan Riley a rest? I think that makes some sense. I think that can make some sense big time. But here's the way the Leafs defense shakes out right now. I have Riley Brody, McCabe Klingberg, Giordano Liljegren with Lagesson and Timmins as spares. Now, you can switch that around a little bit. Riley Klingberg, if you want to go for all fun, and McCabe Brody. I just don't know. Brad Treliving talked about wanting to remodel the Leafs defense. That is the only thing that gives me pause and a little bit of optimism, because this is not a reworked Leafs defense. This is a Leafs defense that lost several parts and added John Klingberg. That is it. And that does not inspire a lot of confidence. The other move that affects the NHL roster in a significant way, and the one that got Leafs Twitter talking until the whole website shut down. Dude, okay, this is going to be a little hiatus in the video. Follow SDPN Sports on Instagram, follow SDPN Sports on TikTok, follow SDPN Sports on YouTube. I've been screaming at you forever. I quit my job for that company. So go over and subscribe to SDPN Sports. We've been just rattling off videos all day and doing a pretty good job, if I do say so myself. Maddie, did we do a good job? We did a great job. SDPN Sports, you don't need Twitter. That website is a tire fire and we'll be out of there momentarily. Anyway, on our YouTube channel, we talked about Ryan Reaves. Now, I like the signing more than most. 3 years at 1.35. Now, listen, he'll be 39 at the end of it. There's no way to make that good. There just isn't. The only way to make that good is it'll be variable by the end of it. That's not a great defense. Oh, we made a signing and we can just shove him in the minors if he's bad. Generally, you like to sign players who you know are good, and that's what's going to make your team better. Here's what's very obvious with the Leafs. 115-point season, 111-point season, and what do we complain about every year? They got pushed around. Not so much 2017 against the Capitals. They did have Tom Wilson. 2018, they got pushed around. 2019, the Bruins pushed them around again. 2020, Pierre-Luc Dubois and the Columbus Blue Jackets pushed the Leafs around. 2021, Montreal came back because they pushed the Leafs around. 2022, Tampa Bay pushed the Leafs around. 2023, the Leafs had a little bit more pushback, and let's be honest, some luck. They finally overcome the Lightning before absolutely getting stuffed in a locker by the Florida Panthers. This happens in so many regular season games. People comparing this to the Matt Martin signing, the Kyle Clifford trade, they gave up assets for that guy, and the Wayne Simmons signing, I think are completely out to lunch. Those guys are fighters. They're some of the most elite fighters. They are not the fighter. Ryan Reaves is the fighter. He's one of the only players in the league whose listed weight is, there's no way. His listed weight is 225. That dude is walking around a lot heavier than that. I saw someone say, what's the difference between Wayne Simmons and Ryan Reaves? 40 pounds listed is the difference. So they've had a vibes problem. He's got immaculate vibes, and they've had a toughness problem. Here's what I hate, and I've said this multiple times. They can't just have one guy do all the fighting. That is not what I want to see with this Toronto Maple Leafs team. We need Ryan Reaves to do what Matt Martin and Kyle Clifford and Wayne Simmons haven't been able to convince the Leafs to do. And that's drag them into the fight. Make them willing to fight. Make it so that the oldest active player in the National Hockey League and Mark Giordano does not have to stick up for Austin Matthews. Have you no pride? This dude is here to give the Leafs some pride. He's going to be on the fourth line. He's going to cost you goals. He's not going to generate a whole lot, and he's going to give up some. I remember in the Leafs-Minnesota Wild game from this year, he wasn't very good. I think it was his first game as a member of the Minnesota Wild as well. But they have a vibes problem. But I look at the team. Here's what I got. Nyes, Matthews, Marner. That's a good first line. It's fun. Got a rookie on it, but it's fun. Yarncroke, Tavares, Nylander. We've seen that work. You could swap Marner there. Oh. Bobby McMahon, David Kampf, Sam Lafferty, who was a healthy scratch in the playoffs, Alex Steeves, Pontus Holmberg, Ryan Reaves. It's July 1st, but that is a cartoon, evil nightmare. Now, there are some good pieces of news. Ilya Samsonov, we're still waiting on a deal there. Matt Murray, we're still waiting on the opposite of a deal there. And there's Joseph Woll. I do like the signing of Maxime Lajoie, and I think it's hilarious because the Leafs signed noted Alan Walsh client, William Lagesson. Lagesson had a great deal of points on the Chicago Wolves in the AHL this year, but he was only third on his team out of defensemen for scoring. And I looked, I said, oh, who was first? It was Max Lajoie. And then about an hour later, Max Lajoie was signed. 11 goals, 34 assists for 45 points in 63 AHL games. Both guys have some NHL experience, but last year, Philip Kroll, Mac Hollowell, Victor Mete, Jordy Benn, Connor Timmins, the Leafs used well into double digits. I think they used over a dozen defensemen last year because of injuries. You're going to need guys like this who can fill in a pinch, and a great story. Two guys from the Toronto Marlies D-Core last year who did not have NHL deals got them today. The first is Noel Hoffenmeyer, who I was disappointed to see go, but he went to the Edmonton Oilers, who love stealing members of the Leafs organization. But the guy the Leafs were able to keep after his first professional season with the Toronto Marlies was Marshall Rafai, 25-year-old. He had 16 points in 69 games. And while the advanced numbers from the AHL aren't the greatest or aren't the most in-depth, his looked pretty good. Part of the reason why those depth signings on D were so important is before they made the Lagesson signing and the others, the Leafs' only three spare defensemen in the minors, according to Cap Friendly, were Topi Niemelä, Mikko Koskinen, and William Villeneuve. All three of those guys could be good. They ain't ready yet. We were an injury away from Mikko Koskinen playing in the Leafs' top six, and to me, that's unacceptable. So look, the Toronto Maple Leafs are worse today than they were in their last game of the playoffs. They're worse today than they were in their last game of the regular season. They're worse today than they were before the trade deadline. They lose Ryan O'Reilly. He's gone to Nashville. They lose Noel Achari, who's going to Kyle Dubas and the Pittsburgh Penguins. They lose Eric Gustafson, who goes to the New York Rangers. No word on Kerfoot, but it sounds like the number one team he's apparently potentially re-signing with is Toronto. Justin Hall goes to Detroit. There's probably some others that I'm missing. They're worse. Now, I still think they're going to make a trade on the back end. Up front, I have no idea. There's a reason people freaked out about Kyle Dubas getting fired when he did. And for me, it wasn't about who Kyle Dubas was. It wasn't about always defending him. In fact, that after last season, that was about as mad as I've ever been at Kyle Dubas. But they took the keys away from a guy who handcrafted the car with 5 weeks to go before the draft. And now July 1st is here. Auston Matthews can sign an extension. He hasn't yet. If Dubas was still the GM, he would have. Mitch Marner, because he wasn't traded. Full no move. We've been talking about Tavares is never going to waive that thing. Marner's never waiving that thing. Never. And William Nylander now has a 10-team no trade list, and he is asking for double digits. Listen, I love William Nylander. I've defended William Nylander since he came into this league. I've defended William Nylander since your uncle had his face on a dartboard. I want no business with a double-digit $10 million asking William Nylander on this team. The core four made too much money for this all to succeed. Kyle had a plan, and it was going great. Then COVID hit, and the world stopped, and the cap stopped going up. That's not his fault. That's not anyone's fault. It is his fault that he didn't move off of that plan. I can tell you what's not going to make that plan better is if they give all guys involved more money. So there are trades that could be made. I'd love to see what they are. I highly doubt the Leafs are done, because if they are, this is a worse team than last year. I counted on them taking a step backward in terms of regular season success, but just looking at this team on paper, literally on paper, I don't see them being a better playoff team either. Matthew Nyes is going to have to contend for the Calder. Lafferty's going to have to show that he's a lot better. McMahon and Steves, Holmberg, they're all going to have to prove they're regular NHL players. Timothy Liljegren is going to have to prove that he's not the type of player who's going to lose his job to Justin Hall in the dying, most important days of the season. This team's in a weird way, and I think this might be a weird summer. So hopefully that didn't freak you out too much. Look up some of those other guys who you hadn't heard of, the depth players. Maybe that'll make you feel better. Maybe they get Max Domi. I'm going to pretend Tyler Bertuzzi wants to sign in Canada, where he was banned from playing. I'm going to assume he wants to sign here for League Men. We'll see. For now, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. SDPN Sports on YouTube. SDPN Sports on Instagram. SDPN Sports on TikTok. SDPN Sports. SDPN Sports. SDPN Sports! On Twitter. Every half an hour when it refreshes. Something like that. SDPN Sports on YouTube. Oh, and Twitch. But mostly on YouTube. We didn't build this thing for nothing.